737-1737 is the number. You can call, you can text, and of course, emails to joe@regjoeshow.com. Joining me in studio, I'm so happy to have him with us, is Still Surfin', in from my native Washington, D.C. Now, we've got with us, and I'm going off the cheat sheet off the website, and I'm not as good as I may be, but on bass, Cal, well, I mean, not playing bass here, but plays bass with the band, Cal Everett, who I just found out we have a really amazing long-term connection, and I'm going to push it just a little bit closer for you guys, playing bass, and then Rob, you are on keyboards and vocals, right? Yep. And then, of course, the founder of the band, Matthew Grose, lead vocals and guitar, back in the corner, Matt Miller, who's on drums, and then one guy not quite here yet. He's going to be in town for the gig tonight, but dealing with the beauty of our current transportation system, wasn't quite able to.
Yes, thank you, Delta Airlines, for the the canceled flight because of mechanical problems. Yes. I think he's in Detroit right now somewhere.
Well, I mean, that's kind of nice. He's in the band, Detroit Music City. There you go. Okay. Gotta look for the positives.
And you know what, Joe? I like the positivity.
Everything we do. So now, you founded the band, was it 2002?
2000.
2000. So, because I'm going to have you, just while we're doing this part, pull a little closer. Okay, just, no problem. Why we have it on the swivel. Now, I met you guys back in 2002.
Yep.
I was telling someone the other day, it was completely on a lark, by the way. I was down in Ocean City, Maryland, on vacation, like we did every year. Literally their first day in town, and one of my family members was looking through they have all the different weekend newspapers, here's all the gigs, and we're both Beach Boy fans, and he goes, hey, do you know what Still Surfin' is? I'm like, oh yeah, it's a single, you know, it was a song off the Summer in Paradise album. And he goes, no, it's a group. And I'm like, no, I don't, and he goes, since they play the Beach Boys, and it was like an hour later. I'm like, well, we have nothing else to do, let's go. So,
by the way, I think you are the first person to ever pull where I got the name from.
Well, I
think you are literally the first person that ever figured out that it's from that song.
And it's a great, it's an underrated, underrated album, underrated song.
I totally agree.
I love the whole feel of the song. I mean, it has to do with just, I mean, again, it's their 30th anniversary album. The whole concept, they're still surfing after all. Anyway, it's a great, great tune.
Oddly enough, we never learned the song. I mean, we probably should have, but we never. It's a really deep track. We only have 90-minute shows to two-hour shows. It's kind of, you kind of got to keep it the cavalcade of hits. You know?
Well, I mean, we've got, 28 days until you're playing the Great American Birthday Bash. I mean, you can learn. No, just no homework. We're not giving homework. So when I met you guys there, I didn't realize you were recording that concert for an album, which I don't know if you realize, but you can hear me cheering at one point on the album.
Can you really?
My wife picked it out. She goes, that's you, isn't it? I said, well, because you guys did. I mean, I was really impressed. I think you were the first Beach Boys tribute band I'd ever seen. Yeah. I mean, because the Beatles, all these guys had them, and the Beach Boys never, at least at that time.
Yeah, so when we started in 2000, there really were not any other Beach Boys. Well, so
Papa Doom,
okay, yeah, but they're not. Are they really a tribute?
I would say they're kind of just a band that just
plays the Beach Boys. The backing band for Jan and Dean, right?
So and they did it well.
So that don't call Don Zarelli. By the way, Don Zarelli is one of the best human beings you'll ever meet.
We've had some great. I've not had him on the show. We've had some great conversations.
He was incredibly encouraging to me.
And needless to say, he and I agree on a lot of things.
Yes, you do.
Which has been one of the fun things I've learned.
You know, Jeff Fosquette as well.
Well, I was going to say, Jeff Fosquette, who for years did falsetto voice for the Beach Boys and for Brian Wilson's band. But even last year, we had a different... I've reached out to you last year, but it was too late. We couldn't get you guys. And we had a band called Surf's Up. Again, we've all agreed on a lot. And I just think it's kind of a fun little side part of the whole deal that so far we've been kind of batting 1,000 on that.
So there was basically us, and maybe I think there was another band. But I think... in the last, 10 years or so, eh, Rob? I mean, I would say the last 10 years or so, there seems to be a lot more of them out there.
It has. And you guys kind of put that trend together. That was one of the things in the concert. I mean, it's on the album. And you guys were doing, you talk about album trip. I mean, you were doing Cherry Cherry Coop. And some great, again.
We used to do Crazy Cutie.
Yeah, I mean, which are you talking about?
That is one of my Playgirls.
Pom-Pom Playgirl.
Oh, my God.
We did Pom-Pom Playgirl for years. Well, but you know what happened? Actually, you know what happened to Pom-Pom Playgirl? About 10 years ago or 8 years ago, we started playing it. We started getting funny looks from people in the crowd.
I was like, you know what? The times have changed.
It was like political correctness killed Pom Pom Playgirl.
But Car Crazy Cutie, also one of the great album tracks that is... I always say the problem with the first 4 or 5 Beach Boy albums, they came out so fast that there's just so much good music, but you can only put so many singles out. I mean, in the sense that they put 2 or 3 singles out, but then the new album's coming out, so they got to promote the new album. a lot of that great music got lost. Yeah. You definitely couldn't do 10 Little Indians off of the Surfin Star. I don't think that would pass no matter what. So
no.
So you put together, and by the way, you and so Matthew and Matt Miller, the drummer, you guys been there since the very beginning.
Yes.
And
yes.
Then
22 years.
This is our 23rd. 23rd year, yeah.
23 years, and you still like each other, which is always good.
Oh, yeah.
So we started, and you said, save for the show.
He used to come over. We've been at my house, and, you know, I mean, Matt does bass vocals, right? He sings a lot of the low parts, back on the drums. But there's some of the songs that it doesn't really need. So when we're working on vocals for a song that he wasn't on, he'd be upstairs, and he'd have my kids, and he'd hold them upside down so they were walking on the ceiling, right? He would literally go upstairs. And,
entertainment, and, you know, no matter what you do.
My son's 24 now, right? So he's.
Can you do that now? He's 24. Yes. So now, when you wanted to put it together, yeah. I mean, did you guys know each other before the band? So what did you just do, like an open call? How did you decide to do this?
Well, so the city paper in D.C., right? So I used to put the, so I put an ad in there, but when I started to do it, the thing was I was playing in a lot of different bands up in D.C., and bars, and you know, it was getting they come in at 3 a.m. It smell of smoke. My wife mm-hmm. maybe have a shower.
I used to DJ in bars at the same time.
Okay,
same kind of thing.
Right, yeah. So you get the idea. So, and when my wife got pregnant with our second child, my daughter, she's like, well, why don't you do the Beach Boys band you wanted to do? And I said, well, because I don't think I'll be able to find musicians that can do it.
Not easy.
And so I started asking my friends. I said, hey, you're people I knew in the community, and I'd say, hey, I want to do a Beach Boys tribute, like a really. And they'd look at me, and I'd get one of two responses typically. I'd either get, really, you want to do an oldies act? Or I would get, you think you could pull that off? Because you can't fake your way through that. Everybody knows exactly what every song is supposed to sound like. You can't fudge it. You can't fake it. They'll know if you're doing it wrong. They won't know what's wrong, but they'll know what's wrong.
Well, one of the things that a lot of critics over the years, and just anyone, you ever watch some of the documentaries where they interview other greats, you know, Crosby, Stills, and Nash, all these, and they'll all tell you something. When it comes to the Beach Boys music, one of the greatest things they did was make it look simple.
Yeah.
And but then you go to try to do it, not so simple.
Deceivingly difficult.
Yeah, I mean,
I
think it was who was the bass player? Why can't I think of her name? She was
Carole King.
Carole King. She always said that. I remember watching an interview. She goes, I was looking at the music. I'm like, this doesn't work. You can't do this.
Right.
And she goes, but then I played it. And it worked. She goes, I don't understand how they did that.
So it was when I was trying to audition people. That's how I met Jeff McAvoy, the photographer.
Okay,
Jeff, yeah.
Who was your original sound?
The original, well, because Jeff came in and he could sing, but he had never really been a performer. And his guitar playing, and he, you know, he liked to play guitar, but he wasn't really a player. And his singing was, he just wasn't a performer. But he was so into it. He was such a great guy. I mean, you're not going to meet a nicer guy than Jeff McAvoy.
And he got to be part of the band. So.
Biggie Mac, right. And so I said, hey, listen, you know, would you do sound for us? Because you know what the songs, and you can blend the music. Now, of course, we have Frank for that.
Who's now on camera, though.
Who's now on camera, yeah.
Now, is that a Van Halen thing on the camera there, by the way, on the other side?
No, that's just something so I can distinguish it from others.
Now, I want to talk more about the band, but can we do a song while we have everyone together here?
Sure.
Old-fashioned, so I'm going to pull the mic back. Just so you can, you're gonna have to do it just like the old days, and work with one mic to do it.
Can do.
If you guys want to do it.
Okay. All right, I'll do like this.
Yep.
There you go.
Okay.
Yep.
So what do you want us to play, Joe?
Well, you mentioned my favorite, so I mean, I don't know if it's too early in the morning for Surfer Girl, but that's my all-time favorite.
That's your all-time. Okay.
That is my all-time
absolutely
favorite.
Absolutely, we will play Surfer Girl. My heart come all undone.
it's done, ladies and gentlemen. That's awesome. Fantastic. Now, can I, hey, guys in the control room, can you do that? No. All right. I didn't think that was going to be the case. So that's what I'm talking about. That's amazing. Now, tonight, you're here in Green Bay. You guys are playing a gig here at the Botanical Gardens, right? That's where you're kicking off the summer?
Yeah. You know, it's bizarre. The last time we were here, actually, Robbie and I, it was over 10 years ago, we played up in... what was the name of the town, Rob?
Marinette.
Oh, Marinette. Yeah.
Yeah, Marinette. Yeah, we did a festival there. Danny and the Juniors opened for us.
But, which would be interesting because Danny's been dead for about 50 years. But I know they had the replacement. Right. Yes.
But the group, Danny and the Juniors, opened for us. And then we haven't been to Wisconsin in a while. Now we got two shows in Wisconsin in less than 30 days.
Well, I mean, it just, that's how you know it's meant to be.
Yes, that's right.
When I did Oldies Radio, I did a bunch of the different concerts. And I always enjoyed when you got... to actually meet the real guys. Like I did when I met the Temptations, there was still two Temptations. Yeah. So it was Melvin Franklin was one of them though. I mean that guy threw with a bass voice. But at the time I worked with the Four Tops, the Temptations, and Martha Reeves. It was all one concert, and it was actually still the original Four Tops. And it was like 40 some years into it. Levi Stubbs hadn't had his stroke yet. But it's those, the music endures for a reason.
Yeah.
I mean you don't find anything now like you used to hear in those days. And I think it's great. I mean, again, the Beach Boys, 60 years. This is they're kind of sort of on their 60th anniversary tour, sort of. I mean, they're not really together. But either way, the music's, I mean, they keep doing events for it. You guys have been at it. That's amazing for 23 years now.
Maybe, yeah. Well,
and you're the young guys.
Mike Love is 83 now. 82. 82?
So, yeah, pretty, I mean, 82. He and Brian
82,
are...
82, I think.
82.
Yeah.
Well, I mean,
Brian's a year younger. Yeah. So Brian, I think, is... maybe 81 and 80, whatever. Point is, yeah, Mike was born in 41 and Brian in 42, I think.
So now people can come out tonight if they want to see it. I just want to make sure I mention that.
Yes, Botanical Gardens tonight.
Botanical Gardens. But more importantly, they can come out on June 30th for our Great American Birthday Bash, which is going to be at Burkle's one block over. Yeah. We were playing a little bit of the two. Before when I played a teaser, I'm like, oh, I forgot to ask them what they're singing. I didn't want to play one of the songs you might do in here. Now, we were talking out there about, so you've met none of us have met Dennis because Dennis passed away in the mid 80s.
Cal, you never.
So, but you've met all of them, right? I mean, Brian as well. So I was saying the only Beach Boy I've never met was Brian, but you've never met Carl, though. You said
I never met Carl.
You know what? That's not true.
Oh, Cal's going to correct you.
I had not correct you. You met Dennis, and I thought, well, I did meet Dennis when I was on tour with the Doctors. We were at some, I think it was the LA Forum or something like that, and there was this thing behind, backstage, you know, green room stuff, and the guy, David Lee Roth from Van Halen was there, and he was there with Dennis.
Oh, no kidding.
No, that's a mix.
Oh, no, that's a dangerous night right there.
I didn't understand it at the time. I didn't even, you know, I was a dumb kid, so I just like, well, wow, this is kind of interesting. But it just jogged my memory, like, yes, he was there, and he was with David Lee Roth.
Yeah.
I could see those two hanging out. Yeah. We've got to hit a break. Can you guys hang in through the break? Do a little more on this. We got to hit a break real quick.
Sure.
We'll be back right after this. I know we've got people hanging on the phones. We will get back to the phones, but we'll be back in just a few minutes with Still Surfin'. If you want to get on phone lines, 888-737-1737. We're going to get at least one more song in before this is all done. This is all part of the preparation for the Great American Birthday Bash. That's